Hi. Who's that? I just know him. So I was in Joburg recently. We toured. We actually went to my friend's 40th birthday, and we decided, no, we're not going to be here during the day. We are going to visit places. And we went to the Eatmore. The Eatmore is Sandton City. Sandton City bores me to death. It looks like the Golden Acre. And everybody is in a hurry. Everybody is walking fast and knocking you out of the way. And I'm like, no, this is not the Road Fighter. Do not play that game no more. Stump in stort in antipathet. It looks like something Herschel Gibbs threw. Honestly, no. We were supposed to leave Joburg at 12 o'clock tonight. We couldn't take it no more. There's no air, there's no sea, there's no mountain, there's too much Trevor Noah posted. Back to Cape Town 11 hours later, we were home. It took us 14 hours up and 11 hours back. That's how much we love Cape Town. love this place. Oh my word. I don't know if you can tell, openly gay. Thank you. That's what I'm looking for. And in Joburg, they aren't openly gay, and I'm not understanding why you would want to hide yourself. Do they think they're going to get their deduction in salary? Because I don't get it. Maybe it's the E. So, yes, I'm openly gay, but everybody knows except my mother. Actually, I'm on Facebook, so the whole world knows that I'm openly gay, but my mother. I confuse that woman. One day I will be blowing. Actually, not even one day. This all happens in the space of a day. One day I'll be doing my hair. I'll be putting a piece in a lipstick. And then the next minute I'm working on my car's engine. She's confused. One moment I'll be doing her hair and painting my nails at the same time. The next moment I'll be playing with my dogs. The woman is confused. She is convinced my godson is my actual son. But his dad is Zulu. So the confusing for her. Shame. I wish the gin was cheap in this place. Last week I was here. I came to come check out the scene, what it's all about. There were less people last week, so I had this confidence boost. Now there's lots of you.
All here for you, Eugene.
Sounded like a white person. So they needed to whiten me up a bit so then the lights came on. Lights. But then I came with my hair and it's not a weave. Thank you. Honestly. Last week I was here and a guy by the name of Sibuyile was something. He was performing and he was talking about, you know, the stereotypes that we have in South. Thank you. Who was that? I don't know, but thanks anyway. Thanks. Sibuyile was talking about his, you know, the stereotypes going on in Cape Town and everything. Flash, thanks. That helps me. That really helps me. He was talking about the stereotypes that we have in South Africa. He was talking about weight loss. So if you are white, excuse me for... Actually, everybody looks white here, so I didn't know what's going on actually. Sibuyile told us about if white people lose weight, everybody else will be proud of them. Wow, the gymming and the dieting is working out. You are losing this weight. You look bad enough. Okay, cool. Colored person loses weight. Woo, the tuck. So all these toxins need to get out of your body. yes, you aren't tough because you cut it and you lost weight. But that's a stereotype thanks to the Daily Voice. Thank you. If you are black and you watch Lucy Dingo sometimes and you lose weight, then you have AIDS. That's... Yeah, I don't get it because everybody gets AIDS. Everybody does. It's sad but true. But now you think about it, if you are a gay guy in Cape Town and you lose weight, then you have all three. The diet wasn't enough. And then you decided to go to gym and you got AIDS there. And to combat the AIDS, to combat the feeling of, oh my God, I have AIDS, I'm going to die, you start thinking. Sad but true. This is South Africa. This is not even Cape Town, it's South Africa. Thank you. Eugene Mathews, that's me. I'm on Facebook and Twitter.